Hello everyone and welcome back to the Red Door Yoga Mini Sutra Series online. It's a pleasure to be with you today. Today I wanted to talk about the idea that your samskaras hide where you won't look. Okay, another way to think of this is that your stuff hides where you won't look. Now, in yoga we call our stuff samskaras, and you'll notice that that word sounds like some scars, and that's you know, kind of to the point here. What samskaras are is they are grooves in our energetic, mental, physical patterns. They're grooves that we get into. The image I kind of want to use today for you guys is that you, your mind and your physicality and everything else that it is the you that you know, is like a dirt road. And it's rained, and so the dirt has become nice and soft, and it's completely smooth. But the moment you drive over that road, you create a groove in it. And then when you drive down that road again, it's because there's a groove there, your eye tends to go towards the groove, and it's a little easy to slide onto that groove again. And every time you go over that groove, every time you pass over that soft dirt road and you go over that groove, the groove gets deeper and deeper and deeper. Now, as it's getting deeper, it actually will grab your tire and pull you into it, okay? So it now becomes a self-perpetuating. It was a self-perpetuating one to begin with the moment you put the groove down, but it becomes more and more self-perpetuating every time you give into that groove, every time you drive into that groove. Okay, so our samskaras are these mental and emotional patterns that we develop where we're creating grooves in our mental makeup, grooves in our energetic and physical makeup. These grooves are there because of our attachments and our aversions that come up during life experiences. Now, when we're having an experience and our attachment or aversion comes up, and we choose to give in to that attachment or give in to that aversion, that's where we slip into the groove. And so the more we give into an attachment and aversion, the deeper the groove gets, which means the more we give into an attachment or aversion. Okay. That's what I really want you to kind of be keeping in your mind here. And these grooves, what they do is over time, they become effectively part of the landscape that we recognize as ourselves. We actually stop, you know, noticing that they are grooves and they are not inherently supposed to be on this road. So you, going back to the analogy of the soft dirt road, you know, after a while, those grooves start to shape the road and you travel this road on a regular basis. And you just think that that's what this road looks like. That's how this road is. But that road is only this way because you keep traveling in a particular way over it. So our samskaras, these grooves, they hide where we won't look. They become difficult for us to see because they hide in the places, especially that we either think are who we are, or they hide in the places that we don't want to look at, things that we find too uncomfortable about ourselves. So these grooves, as I mentioned, they are mental, energetic, you know, physical grooves, and so they are in us. So we need to be willing to look at ourselves closely. And all of us, myself included, when you look at yourself closely, there are going to be things that you will see that you're not so keen on. So that's where our samskaras hide the most. And that is why we must be willing to see ourselves plainly, see ourselves clearly, see ourselves in the way we are behaving, not in the way we want to be, but in the way we are being, okay? And as we are willing to look at ourselves and we're willing to see the things that we tend to deem as undesirable and unattractive, you know, again, physically, emotionally, mentally, you know, we're talking personality characteristics. When we're willing to see this, when we look at ourselves, we will start to be able to see the samskaras, and we will be able to start to differentiate the samskaras from who we actually are. And at that point in time, we can weaken those samskaras. And as the samskaras weaken, it becomes like starting to smooth that road back out. Effectively, the groove starts to lift out of the dirt again, lift out of the mud, and the mud becomes smoother and smoother and smoother until we effectively return back to who we really are. I hope this was helpful, everyone. If you have questions, please do put it in the comment section below. If you enjoyed the video, like, please share it with others. Sharing is how we expand our community, and we're able to get this philosophy out to others so that it can help to decrease their suffering as well. If you find us on Facebook, it's easy to like and share. If you find us on YouTube, please subscribe to the channel. You know, you can share it from YouTube as well. If you are interested in putting this into this philosophy into more practice, you've got a couple of options. We have the RDY Self-Mastery group that is attached to the Red Door Yoga Facebook page that you can join. It's a free group. And we also have the Masterful Path Mentorship Program, which is a program that I run where I'm specifically mentoring students through this learning and through applying it to their lives so that they can integrate this and really kind of get a hold of this and live by this. We only open the doors to the mentorship program twice a year, so if the doors are currently closed, just go to themasterfulpath.com and you can add yourself to the wait list. And as soon as the doors are open, I will be certain to let you know. Okay? It was lovely being here with you, everyone. Have a great rest of your day, wherever, whenever you are, and we will see you again online very, very soon.
Namaste.